All right, Elton, a few games of the week, right, especially compared to last week. Which game should we focus on?
I think there are a couple trap games out there, okay?
The mighty trap games.
Yes. Iowa State at West Virginia. Iowa State, obviously, is this season's Cinderella team. They're going on the road to West Virginia. Iowa State's coming off a big win, home win over TCU. But West Virginia's been in and out of top 25 all year. West Virginia can get them at can get Iowa State at home if Iowa State's not careful. The other one, trap game, is Penn State at number 24, Michigan State. Michigan State's coming off a loss, returning home. Obviously, Penn State's coming off a crushing loss. You know, will they be able to return and recover off of that? You know, there's a couple other games. I'll let you chime in on Alabama, LSU, and Clemson, North Carolina State. You know, how do you see those two?
Well, Alabama, they had the week off last week, so Saban with a week off is, I don't know what his record is, but I'm sure it's pretty darn good.
Yeah.
And that won't stop as they play LSU. And the other game?
Other game was Clemson and North Carolina State.
Clemson, North Carolina State, NC State just lost to Notre Dame.
Yeah.
So that's going to be an interesting thing. And here's the thing about Clemson, and you and I talked about this before. I think despite their loss, mm-hmm, I think it's going to come down to them in Miami. I know, but for that to happen,
right, you
know, they're going to have to beat NC State,
right,
who's been a very good team,
right,
at home.
I think people are kind of forgetting about Clemson in this mix, too. Clemson can still get into the mix as one of the four teams in the playoffs. I still think they're viable there. Of course, they have to win out like several other teams and have a couple things fall their way. But I still think that's in their window of opportunity. So, I don't think they'll be looking past North Carolina State at all.